Hello, boys, girls, SPLC commissars. My name is Kyle Broderick. Welcome to the Kinder, Gentler Social Regressive. We're going to be taking a look at some 6.5 Creedmoor hand loads, not getting a really close look, mind you. I wouldn't want to show you how to actually make these. If you want to find out something horrible like that, you'd probably have to go to the link down in the description below, which takes you to my Patreon page where I'll have the full video. We'll just take kind of a broad view of these, what the overall results were, and a little bit of an idea of the winding road that it took to get to a pretty solid subsonic performance. We're using Hodgdon Trail Boss. This is the featured powder today. We're going to be doing some supersonic loads. You might have seen that in a previous video, using Alliant Reloader 16, where we got some excellent results with 6.5 Creedmoor. But for now, we're slowing things down, and we want to use a pistol powder like this. Trail Boss is well known as being a powder that's going to fill up a case and going to keep velocities pretty low without, you know, some of the issues that you might get into if you have too little of a certain rifle powder. So this is going to get good consistent ignition. And actually, this is where the story gets kind of interesting too. We are going to be loading up 140 grain hot core bullets from Spear. These are Spire Point flat base. And the reason that I chose that is because it should be very, very stable. If you have some of the longer bullets with boat tails, those are going to really want high twist rates and they're going to want a lot of speed. The rifle that we're testing all of this out in is a Savage Stealth Evolution at 6.5 Creedmoor. And this has a high twist rate of 1 in 8. But considering the speeds that we're going to be backing this down to, I wanted a bullet that I was going to be pretty well sure that it wasn't going to tumble at these low speeds, and especially as things got further out. I could see how maybe if I were using the 140 grain ELD match bullets, those are extremely long, and I could see how maybe out past 200 yards or something, they might start to tumble all over the place. Maybe it's not a big deal, and maybe it wouldn't even happen, but I decided to play it safe. And especially considering this type of bullet and what it's for, this is for good terminal performance on game. And that's what I would want to use subsonics for, maybe for hunting vermin, you know, if I have some kind of pest animal that's coming around a homestead or something, or I want to be able to really quietly take a game, like maybe even, I know it's a big bullet for rabbits or anything like that, but yeah, some smaller game, maybe coyotes at closer range. I think this would be a good bullet for that. Making ammunition is a lewd and dangerous act only suitable for adults. I'll give you a taste here in this little video montage, but I'm going to censor out all the good bits. I won't show you how to use the equipment, so stop asking, but I will at least give you a laundry list of the equipment that I'm using in this test. I'm using the RCBS full-length die set, which I highly recommend. The RCBS Trim Pro 2, which I highly recommend, especially if you're going to be reloading for a whole bunch of different case types and you want to be able to trim those down to the correct specs. This is going to be one that is kind of agnostic for any particular case. You can make this work for anything, including wildcats. And then to pour powder, I'm using the RCBS Chargemaster Lite, which I have previously reviewed and I highly recommend. Finally, I seeded the bullets using the RCBS cedar die. So how about some results? I can't show you how I got to my destination, but I can at least show you the destination, I think. Let's hope that YouTube doesn't have any problems with that. So yeah, I have a setup right here, and the velocities, the first time that I went out, everything just didn't work out right. It was too cold, the chronograph didn't work quite right. Actually, a lot of my equipment was failing because of the cold. I have marked here 10 degrees Fahrenheit, but it could very well have been colder than that. There was a pretty brisk breeze going on too. Yeah, that one didn't work. Tried again with a very similar setup, almost the exact same thing. And velocities were just kind of ranging all over the place. This was 70 degrees Fahrenheit, and I actually ended up getting a bullet stuck in the chamber because velocities dropped off precipitously. I kept trying to figure out if something was, you know, actually happening, what was going on, and ended up getting one stuck in the barrel. And I was able to tap it out later, no problem. And that was supposed to be my last shot of the day. But then I made a change, and I can't tell you what that change is. You'll have to go see the full video on Patreon to go see that. Thank you, YouTube, for your kind indulgence. But I did end up finding a decent velocity. I got everything seemed to get a bit more consistent after the change. And I'm shooting for that 1,050 to 1,080 feet per second mark. And it looks like I'll be able to get that with this unspecified charge. In the final analysis, I think we ended up with a good subsonic 6.5 Creedmoor load. I think it's going to be consistent, stable. I think we're going to be able to actually shoot this out at longer range, which is one of the tests that I want to do. I want to see how far away we can be and still hit something like this target right here. I also want to do a sound test because I'm really curious to hear what this bullet sounds like going past a microphone at those slow speeds. We've done a whole bunch of other tests before with supersonic 223, subsonic 223, subsonic 22 long rifle, supersonic 6.5 Creedmoor, and we've gotten some interesting sounds, including that Hollywood pew sound that everybody kind of thought was a myth. It's a real sound made by a real bullet, and you know, maybe not under the conditions that we see in Hollywood movies, but I want to hear if this creates that same sound. This is not a hollow point for the first time. And maybe it's the hollow point that creates that sound. Maybe it's a standing wave created behind the projectile. I've heard all kinds of, you know, rumors and guesses in the comments as to why it makes that sound, but we're gonna see if this does it. And again, if you wanna see the full video on exactly what I did to arrive at this load, then go to my Patreon page and I'll have the full uncensored video there. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, be sure to like, share, and most importantly, subscribe. Even if you didn't like this particular content, go ahead and subscribe. There's probably something coming that's more up your alley. Check out this playlist right here. This is going to have videos in a similar vein to what you just watched. These two videos we cherry-picked for you. And finally, The Social Regressive is on Patreon. So you can become a patron of the destructive arts and earn some goodies while helping us to provide high-quality videos just by kicking us a few bucks a month. Thanks a bunch for your patronage.